Hi folks, CloudShots here with another potato cam video. This will just be demonstrating Windows 3.0 on my eclectic Tandy 1000 RL setup. I do have the single ISA slot populated with a Diamond SpeedStar VGA adapter. You'll see why. We have a whopping 322K free. So what can we do with that? The desktop resolution and color depth you're seeing here is 1024 by 768, 256 colors. All right, so that image is going to take about 2 minutes to open. It's got to build the edit layer. So I'll talk about some of the other system specs right now. I do have an internal 40 megabyte hard drive from which Windows is running. Aside from that, I do have a parallel SCSI adapter. It's one of the few interfaces that will actually work on the parallel port that is still missing a line. So this interface does work. I do have a 1 gigabyte iOmega Jazz drive attached to that, from which most of what I'll be showing here is actually running from. So the temporary directory is set up on that, so that's why you're seeing the activity there. The Tandy 1000 RL is Tandy's low-end system for 1990. It's got a 9.54 megahertz 8086 processor, so this is not stuff you'd typically see done on this type of system. It's got 640K usable system memory. You'll often see 768 in reference to this system, the other 128, of course, being the video memory. MIDI-wise here, so I am leveraging the single serial port the system offers for both the mouse. The reason being is the built-in mouse port on the system does not have a compatible driver with Windows right now, so I'm using serial for that and switching between it and the MIDI setup via just this little switch box. And I'll show off the MIDI stuff here in a bit, because that's not typical for this type of arrangement either. So yeah, not... I don't know that anyone would have the patience to do a lot of photo editing on this type of system, but it is kind of cool to see a 800 by 600 resolution picture in 256 color on such a low-end system. So we'll minimize that. And I haven't talked about the other monitor here, but you'll see why that is here in just a little bit too. So we've got those things open. Prince of Persia. normally you'd hear this system on a Tandy with the Tandy music, and this having the PSSJ with the digital analog converter, you'd also hear digital samples. However, I have a limitation in that because I'm using the parallel port for the SCSI adapter, I can't use the digital audio of this system. Isn't that great? I only have one free hand here, so I'm not that bad of a player, really. So having that VGA adapter in here does allow you to do, well, you know, use a lot more software than you might otherwise with just the Tandy graphics. Not to say there isn't Tandy support with the Prince of Persia, it's just the VGA support looks a lot better. Okay. So MIDI-wise, I've created these little batch files. Each one represents playback of a distinct XG MIDI album using Mark Fontana's, this is a later version of his GS Play software. So here's kind of where with my batch file, I have to, prompt it to switch over because I lose my mouse capability and have to switch over to MIDI. And with the 8250 UART that the Tandy RL has, you wouldn't necessarily think they'd be capable of driving full MIDI resolution, but it does, and I'm doing it. The 38,400 bits per second rate, not necessarily that it's sending that much at any given time. You may also wonder why I'm wasting such a high-end, or comparably high-end MIDI module on this system, but the dual purpose of it here is that it's also acting as a serial to MIDI converter for the MT32 playback, which I'll demonstrate here in just a minute too. Switch back to the mouse. We're back in Windows. Okay. Now, the reason I've got this other monitor here is there's a little utility that Jeffrey Hayes wrote called vSwitch. It's used in conjunction with another little program called vsres. So with that, it allows you to switch between an external graphics adapter and the onboard graphics chipset just by, issuing the vSwitch command to do that. And so if you set up batch files properly, I've got a bunch of King's Quest and Space Quest, Sierra titles here. So if I launch any of these, I've set it up so that in the background it'll call that vSwitch program and switch over here. Because these the games look better on this CM11 monitor, of course, than on a full resolution LCD. At least I think so. And of course, we still get the benefit of the Tandy PSG music with these, which, of course, when we're talking the AGI adventures, they are going to sound best with that. Now, getting into the SCI adventures, like Space Quest 3, Police Quest 2, and Quest for Glory, and you know, its earlier counterpart, Heroes Quest. With those, they support the MT32 for what's considered the best music there. So, you know, given that I don't have a sound card on this system, or you know, a MIDI adapter itself, I'm leveraging that serial port again through the MU50. Play back that MT32 music, but I also had to modify Sierra's drivers to send the MIDI data to the serial port, so that was actually quite a bit of fun. So here's what that looks like and sounds like. I like this illegal data message on the MU50 that it gets, you know, without receiving anything. I'm also sending the MIDI message to the MU50 to basically bypass its internal tone generator and send all the MIDI data straight to the MIDI out, so we don't get duplication of the music through the MU50 for any of this. It just goes in and straight out to the MT32. So that's all we hear. And this game actually pushes the limits of an 8086, in my opinion. I don't know that I actually want to play this game on this system. The fighting sequences in particular are a bit slow. So there you go. Now, from just DOS itself, not running it through Windows, I can actually get a number of the VGA games that have MT32 support to play on the system. Even as far as some of the general MIDI ones, I modified that driver too. You know, the issue being that they just don't run that great on this system. It's just not capable in a lot of respects. So it's not anything I would personally do. All this waiting just to close this program, isn't that great? Although I did want to demonstrate that it does pull up a, you know, a whole lot faster since it's already done that, you know, translation effort in the background. It's just pulling up the data straight out of the temp directory. I mean, there's certainly more you could do in Windows 3.0 on this system. There are versions of Microsoft Word and Excel that would run on this. With my Tandy 1000 SL and it having, you know, quite a bit more flexibility with the number of ISA slots, or ISA slots, you know, on that system I was able to actually play MIDI within Windows. I also had an EMS RAM card in that system as well. But this is still very usable. It's very responsive as well, in my opinion, you know, as long as you stick within like a 3-program limit as far as open programs go. But there you go.